In this video, I'm going to work out a complex partial fraction decomposition antiderivative problem. So the integral is going to be 4x minus 2 divided by 16x to the fourth minus 1 dx. Okay, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to do work on this side of the board. Okay, to make it easier. So first we need to factor 16x to the fourth minus 1, right? So that can be factored as 4x squared minus 1, 4x squared plus 1. So notice that the second factor is a prime factor. It cannot be factored, but the first one can. So we can do it as 2x minus 1, 2x plus 1, and then 4x squared plus 1. So, now we can rewrite this fraction and try to decompose it. And it will be decomposed as a divided by the first factor plus b divided by the second factor plus cx plus d divided by the third factor, right? Because it's a quadratic prime factor. That's why we have to have two constants, and the first constant multiplies dx. Okay, so now if we multiply both sides of this equation by this denominator, we will have only the top remaining. A will have to multiply these two guys, right? 2x plus 1 times 4x squared plus 1. And then plus b, b will have to multiply this one and that one. So 2x minus 2 times 4x squared plus 1. And then cx will multiply 2x minus 1 and 2x plus 1. 2x minus 1, 2x plus 1. And then finally, the d will multiply these two guys as well. 2x minus 1, 2x plus 1. Okay, as you can see, this is a very tedious and long work with the constants. So let's start with x to the third, right? Because that's the highest power. X to the third on the left side is 0 because there's no x to the third. So 8a, right? Because x squared times x is x to the third. So a is the coefficient of that. And then the same thing, we get 8b. And then let's see, x to the third, 4c, right, plus 4c. Right? Now x squared. X squared is also 0 on the left side. There's no x squared there. So x to the third plus 2x plus 4x squared. So 4a. X squared, minus 4x squared, so minus 4b, x squared for c, here, plus 2x, oh, but it's subtracted, yeah, so c doesn't participate. The d, 4x squared, right, plus 4d, plus 4d. Now, x to the first power, 4, we finally have the left side. 2a, right? X to the first power. 2b. X to the first power. That's going to be minus c, right? And no x to the first power for d, because they cancel out. Constant. Negative 2, right? A, right? 1 times 1, that's easy to locate, minus b, c doesn't participate, and then minus d. So now you might think, oh, how do I do that? Well, if we multiply, take a look at this, if we multiply this by 4, we will get 8a and 8b. And you see, we already have 8a and 8b in the first equation, so we can solve for c this way. So subtract the first equation from the third. Third minus the first. And we get 16 minus 0 is just 16, right? 8a minus 8a, 0. 8b minus 8b, 0. Minus 4c. Minus 4c is minus 8c. So c is equal to negative 2. Bingo, we found the c. Now, same thing. Look at this. There's minus 4a minus 4b, and we can multiply this by 4, right? And then we can solve for d, right? That way, because the a and b will be gone. So we will have so fourth minus the second equations. Okay, so we'll have negative 8 is equal to a's and b's are canceled. Okay, and then minus 4d is negative 8d, so same thing, but d this time is negative 1. Oh, sorry, oops, not negative 1, positive 1, right? Minus 8 divided by minus 8. Now, you might say, wait a second, so we have c and d, what can we do? We have c and d. Well, we can basically do something vertically again, since we know the c and d. Let's actually substitute for these two equations, okay? So without the multiplication of 4, just inner. So we have 4 is equal to 2a plus 2b minus c, so plus 2. Right? I'm just substituting the c and d for these last two equations. Then minus 2 is equal to a minus b minus d and minus 1. Right? So that means this means that 2a plus b, right, because the 2 is the common factor, it's the coefficient common, is equal to 4 minus 2, right? Subtracting 2, so it's going to be 2. So a plus b is equal to 1. Okay, and here we can rewrite this as a minus b is equal to negative 2 plus 1, right? If we add 1 on both sides, we get a minus b. So a minus b is negative 1. So now look what happens. If I add these two equations, if I add these, the b's will be gone and 2a will be equal to 1 minus 1. That's going to be 0, right? So a is equal to 0. Okay, so that means that b is equal to 1, right? So let's see. So that means we found our coefficients, right? These and these. So now we can rewrite this integral. A over 2x minus 1. What is a? 0, right? So we don't have to worry about that. Plus b. What is b? B is 1. So 1 over 2x plus 1 plus c. What is c? Negative 2. Negative 2x. What is d? Plus 1 over 4x squared plus 1. 4x squared plus 1 dx. Okay, so that's going to be fairly easy, because using the u substitution here, du will be 2, so we will get 1 half. So 1 half ln of absolute value 2x plus 1, right? And here, we're going to have to split this integral. We're going to have to split this as minus 2x over 4x squared plus 1 dx plus 1 over 4x squared plus 1 dx. Okay? This will be done by the u substitution. The du will be 8x. So we will have 1 8th negative 2 divided by 8 will be negative 1 over 4, right? So it's going to be minus 1 over 4 ln, of course, right? ln of 4x squared plus 1, no need to have the absolute value, right? And then the, this remaining integral, if you use the u substitution, you will be able to use arctan. So you will use 2x, because notice that u squared will be 4x squared precisely, right? And the du will be equal to 2dx, right? So you will need to multiply this integral by 1 half, the last integral. So it's going to be 1 half arctangent of u, right? And the reason why I know is that you're going to have this, right? U squared plus 1, right? U squared is 4x squared du, right? So you would get 1 half arctangent of u, and u is 2x, right? Substitution plus a constant. So there goes your long antiderivative. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video.